was yesterday. Officers are spread out across the community. Yesterday, they were focused in this area just down the hill from the school here. The sheriff says Halfacre stole a cop car just down there, crashed it, and then ran up into the woods back beyond that shopping center there. Now, today, police think Dwayne Halfacre might want to come here since the school is empty today. While the search is still on for this robbery suspect, these schools were closed today.
He's extremely dangerous, and we want to take caution on him.
Superintendent Mark Griffiths says officers are patrolling the school constantly. He and other administrators doing walkthroughs inside every few hours.
It's nice and warm in there. Obviously, there's food in there. We don't want him to knock out a window and get in there.
Not far from the search, this Raceway gas station is helping out the officers.
He's not used to that, you know, somebody from out of town just shows up, you know, wrecks a car.
Darren Rogers says he noticed how tired all of the officers looked during yesterday's search and offered to bring them chicken. Now, he says anytime during their search, they can stop by and get food for free.
They've just been working hours and hours and hours, and they've got our full support, and we hope they catch them.
Rogers says he wanted them to know the community supports them and wants others to know that despite all of this, Whipple is still a great town.
Bad guys, don't bring it around here, because we'll band together and we'll put you back out on the road.
Spoke with the superintendent just before we came on the air here, and he says they're still trying to decide what to do tomorrow about school. He's still in touch with the sheriff regularly to see how this search is going and if they should have the kids back here at school tomorrow. For now, reporting live in Marion County, Brittany Martin, News Channel 9.
All right, Brittany, thank you. Today we spoke with Dwayne Halfacre's wife, and she tells us she's shocked her husband would do something like this, but she says he does have a history of addiction. She says she prays for her husband and hopes that he is found safely.
His family, you know, including me, we're all just worried sick. When we saw it on the news, you know, it just has devastated us, and we're just worried, completely sick about him, because we don't know, you know, like I said, we don't know anything about him.
Halfacre is wanted out of Rutherford County for robbing two store clerks last Friday. He also has warrants for burglary and vandalism in Marion County and a probation violation out of Moore County, as well as several charges out of Georgia, including robbery and aggravated assault. According to the TBI, Halfacre is 42. He has several tattoos and scars. He has tattoos on his stomach, his arms, his leg, his chest, and back. Again, he is considered armed and dangerous.
The fate of the man accused of